The gangs of House Delaque are renowned for their skills in espionage and subterfuge. A key feature of these gang members are their long greatcoats and their bold, pallid heads. Now, in this video, we're going to be taking you for a step-by-step guide on how to paint one of these sinister figures. So when you're ready, let's get started. Before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey. This is a nice neutral colour for all the colours we'll be applying onto this figure. Now, the first colour we'll be doing is Dried Bark, and this is going to be over his overcoat, including his sleeves as well. So I'm just giving it a quick shake, and then I'm going to use a medium base brush, just get a little dollop or two there on my palette, and a touch of water as well. This basically just stops it being quite a thick, goopy paint, makes it less resistant when you start applying to the model. So what we're going to do now is start applying it all over the overcoat. So the first thing we're going to do is just slap it all over here, like so, like the front of the overcoat. Now, you've got other details around, but actually you don't have to be too neat at this point because you can paint those later. Now I'm going to do a couple of thin coats on here just so I get a nice smooth coverage. And there we are with his overcoat now base coated brown. We're going to move on to the next step. Now what we're going to do is a quick highlight or dry brush using Steel Legion Drab. Now this is the perfect time to do it because you can be a bit messy and there's not lots of other colours that are pre-painted to consider and avoid. So what I'm going to do is get a small dry brush. It's going to apply a little bit of Steel Legion Drab to some paper. It's going to wipe off as much as I can. Still leave a little bit on it, so this is like a light dry brush. Then what we're going to do is start applying it actually onto the model. Now the thing you're going to see here is there's lots of folds in the cloth which are going vertical, so we need to go horizontal with our dry brush in here. So all I'm going to do is just go sideways like so, all the way up to the cloth. You do this all around. Now you do have to consider sometimes it changes, so here where the straps are, they're actually going horizontal, so my dry brushing now needs to be vertical. So just make those changes and adjustments as you go around the model. With a dry brush of Steel Legion Drab now done, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply shade. And for this, we'll be using Norn Oil. So I'm just going to use a medium shade brush for this. It's going to load up my brush, but I'm going to use the palette just to obviously not have so much on the brush because you don't want to flood the model. So I'm just going to load that up nicely, like so, give it a bit of a twist to get a nice point. And then what I'm going to do is start applying this all over the robes. Now, this is going to do two things. First of all, it's going to get into all those recesses and really darken down, but it's just going to knock back that Steel Legion Drab a little as well. Just give it a nice subtle highlight. As you can see, I'm just doing this all over the overcoat. With that shade now applied and dry, it's really toned down that brown. So what we're going to do now is we're going to do some highlighting using Carrick Stone. Now there's two ways we're going to do this. We're just going to pick out some raised details as a highlight, but also to give it a nice worn, weathered feel, we're going to do some scratchy effects as well. So I'm using a small artificer brush here. I'm going to apply a little bit to my palette, and a little bit of water as well. And when you're doing fine highlights, sometimes adding a little bit more water will just mean it won't dry on your brush too quick. So you can just spend a bit more time being a bit neat about those highlights. So I'm just going to get to a nice point and then we're going to start doing it. So first of all, some of the folds on his actual overcoat here are quite obvious little ones. So I'm just going to just do a little highlight there, and a little highlight there, like so. So that's just a standard highlight. Now some of the bigger folds around the base of his actual overcoat, what I'm actually going to do here is just like little flicks. It's almost like cross hatching. So you don't have to, you can go in any direction you want to, so I might just change the direction here as well. And again, just make sure your paint's nice and thin down when you do this as well. Just take your time. And there we are with that highlight now done. It's given a nice warm weathered effect to that leather overcoat. So what we're going to do now is we're going to pick out the piping details that just go around the edge of the overcoat, and we'll be using Towel Light Ochre for this. So I'm going to keep using my small artificer brush. Just going to apply a little bit to my palette, a little touch of water as well, just mainly to prevent it from drying on my brush. A nice twist to get to a nice point, and we'll start picking those bits of piping out. So basically what they're going to be doing is they're running all the way around where the clasps are and just around the top of his hood and also the base of his jacket. All I'm going to do is just use the edge of the brush and just pick them out. With the piping now done, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to paint all the metallic details. Now to start with, we're going to be using lead belt to pick out all the silver details. We're going to use Retributor Armor to pick out the gold details. Then we're going to shade them both with Norn Oil and highlight them both with Stormhost Silver. So to start with those metal areas, I'm just going to get some lead belt onto my brush. I'll just thin it down a tad. We'll start picking them out. You'll mostly find this on the guns, to be fair. So what we'll start doing is just picking out all those areas. So I'm going to paint the whole of the gun. There are other areas on the gun which will paint other colours, but just for ease at the moment, I'm just going to paint the whole gun with lead belcher. With the silver areas done, we're now going to pick out the gold areas using Retributor Armor. This is like his big belt buckle. He's also got some little clasps here as well, so I'm just going to pick those out. There's other details like his face rebreather. And if you're not sure, just check the box art for details. With the gold now applied, we're going to use Norn Oil. We're going to shade all those metallic areas we've just painted. For this, I'm using a medium glaze brush, as it's nice and small and it's perfect for doing small areas with shades. With the shade now dry, we're going to use Stormhost Silver and highlight all these metallic areas. So things like the daggers, just going to use the edge of the brush like so, just pick out some of those raised areas. I'm trying to get like where the sun's probably going to be touching as well, so you try and keep it to the top parts of any kind of details. Just going to do that on all the gold details and the silver details as well. And there we are, with the silver areas now highlighted, we're going to move on to painting some red details. Now for this we'll be using Corn Red, we're going to shade with Norn Oil, and then going to highlight with Evil Sun Scarlet. And in some places we'll just pick out some fine art edge highlights using Wild Rider Red. So I'm just going to get my small artificer brush, add a little bit of Corn Red to my palette, just thin it down ever so slightly, and then we're going to start painting. Now there's only a couple of places we need to put red. You've got the gun casings here, I'm just going to pick out those. But also, down the sides where his like, little straps are on his coat, there's actually some markings. If you see the box art, you'll notice this. So what I'm going to do is just do a nice rectangular shape just going down there underneath those straps. I'm not going to paint the straps at the top, just the bits underneath. With those red details now base coated, I'm just going to shade the gun casings using Norn Oil. Those designs on the legs, I'm going to leave them as they are for the moment. They don't need shading. With the shade now dry, I'm just going to edge highlight those red casings using a little bit of Evil Sun Scarlet. So as always when doing edge highlight, I just use the edge of your brush where possible to pick out those raised details. And also down the markings on the side here, I'm just going to layer over. It still showed some of that Corn Red in the recesses. With that first highlight now done, we're just going to finish off the gun casings with a few fine highlights of Wild Rider Red. And these are almost just like little blink points in corners. Nothing too much, it's nice and fine. For this I'm using a small artificer brush. With the red details now done, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to paint the Delaque skin. Now for this we'll be starting off with Iron Rack skin. So I'm going to continue using my small artificer brush, I'm going to apply a little bit to my palette, and again I'm going to thin this down. You might want to do a couple of layers of this as well. I'm just going to load that brush, it'll get a nice point to it, and we'll start painting it. Now he's got a couple of little eye bits as well, which we'll be painting black in a bit, but for the moment I'm just going to paint over that because we can always add paint later. Like I said, just do a couple of thin coats and don't forget his hands as well. With the skin now base coated, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply a shade. Now to add a bit more warmth to this very pallid and cold looking skin tone, I'm going to use Reichland Flesh Shade. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to my brush, keep it to a nice point just by mixing some on my palette. There we are, so it's not too overloaded. Now I'm going to try and keep this to the recesses as well. But if you do make any mistakes and splodge all over, then don't worry, you can always tidy it up after. So I'm just going to run that around his eyes, around his ears. There's obviously quite a few areas where this will sink into anyway. And where his fingers are, just keep that into the recesses of his fingers. With that shade now dry, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to highlight up using Deepkin Flesh. Now normally when I do highlights, I'll pick out like the raised details like the nose, the knuckles, ears, brows and stuff like that. But the first thing I'm going to do before we do any of that, so I'm going to thin down the Deepkin Flesh a bit more than I normally would, so probably two parts water, one part Deepkin Flesh. What we're going to do is I'm going to concentrate this around the top of his head where his bald head is. So I'm just going to make this a little bit thinner and just give it a nice subtle transition as well. So sometimes if you apply too much paint onto large surfaces like that, it can look quite chalky. So what I'm going to do is a couple of thin layers on his bald head, Deepkin Flesh. You'll notice when it's dry, it'll look a little bit more subtle. With the Deepkin Flesh now applied, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to do some final highlighting. This is just on extreme details where the light will catch. And for this, we're going to use Pallid Witch Flesh. So I'm just going to get a little bit on my brush, thin it down ever so slightly as well. And again, I'm just going to concentrate this on things like knuckles, brows, a bit of the nose as well. But just extreme fine highlights if you can. You don't have to go too mad. So what I'm going to do is just like little bits, because it's slightly lighter than the Deepkin Flesh, you'll just see it spot here and there. And if I do it on the knuckles as well, let them stand out as well. With the skin now done, we're going to move on to the final detail of the Delaque, and that is to paint the black details. Now for this, we're going to start with a Baden black, we're going to highlight with Dark Reaper, and we'll just do some spot highlights here and there with Fenrisian Grey. Now first of all, I'm just going to mix my Baden black onto my palette and a little bit of water. There's only a couple of details to worry about. Actually, I'll add a little bit more water because we're going to do the eyes first, and having that a bit more thinned down will be a lot easier to paint. So what we're going to do is just concentrate around these two eye bits here. So I'm just, because I've thinned it down ever so slightly, it should run in those recesses a bit easier. Got the two eye bits to do. He's also got a little bit on his side there, like an ear receiver. We have his rib reaver tube as well, which goes all the way around the back. And then there's these handles of his guns as well. The black now base coated, we're going to move on to highlighting. And to start off with, we're going to use Dark Reaper. So I'm just going to pick out where his eyes are, like so. There's also his rebreather here, so I'm just going to start going across those. Just picking out those raised bits. We go around the back as well, it's got like the, I suppose, the rebreather unit. So I'm just going to highlight all the edges. Also, failed to mention, he's also got some boots at the bottom now. These are quite subtle, so they're just poking out through the fronts. But other models, they might be more prominent. And they will also be black. Like the rest of the details we're doing now. And finally, we're going to finish off the black by applying Fenrisian Grey as a fine highlight. So I'm just going to pick out like some little bits on the eyes like so. Do that bit again. There we are. That's much better. And I'm just going to move across on the rebreather tube. Pick out some little bits here and there. You don't have to go mad. Also, when I go to his belt and stuff and like the rebreather unit at the back, just little bits, just on the edges and corners. And once you've done this, just paint your ganger's base the same as the rest of the gang. With the model now painted and based, he's ready to head off into the Underhive and sabotage the other houses. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any highlighting, always keep your brush to a nice point and also take your time when doing it. And secondly, when doing any shading, try not to overload your brush, otherwise you'll start to swamp the details of the figure. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Delaque gangers, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.